Hi, my name is Oliver Wildersmith, and I'm a doctoral student in the Computational Behavioral Science Lab at Northeastern University. And here, we use technology to answer important research questions about autism. So I grew up outside of Boston in Massachusetts, and I was interested in a whole bunch of different things as a kid. I was definitely one of those kids who always took things apart and was always interested in how things worked and in technology. But I was also always fascinated by people, and I particularly was really interested in children, and as a teenager got the opportunity to work at a place that it was an after-school program for children with special needs, with a variety of disabilities, including autism, and I really became fascinated by those kids and the sort of amazing constellation of strengths and challenges that they faced, and I was really interested in that. I definitely remember one child with who I worked with who oftentimes would seem to sort of, people talk about like blow up, and it would seem to come out of the blue, which understandably meant many of his classmates, many of his teachers and counselors were uneasy around this child because they felt like they had no idea when, you know, he might have an outburst of some sort. It wasn't until several years later, when I was working at the MIT Media Lab and starting to use some of the psychophysiological sensing equipment, that I started to learn that, in fact, in many cases, those kinds of events may not come out of nowhere. In fact, they may be, slowly building up inside a child over time, but the child's just not showing the outward signs that we're used to seeing. And that was one of the first things that really got me excited about how we might use technology, because it was essentially a way of using this technology, for example, to allow a caregiver in real time to see the stress level of a child. The technology was a way to bridge that gap and to help that child communicate so that they could get their needs met. So I'm really interested in understanding sort of the underlying dynamics of social interaction and relationships. In order to look at those things, I use a variety of different tools. So that includes wearable sensors, things that measure stuff like heart rate or skin conductance. These are sensitive measures of a person's sort of internal state, of how activated a person is, as well as things that tell us about how a person's behaving. So we use a variety of different camera systems. We use cameras that are embedded in the environment. And then we work to bring all of that information together to get a better understanding of the underlying dynamics, the synchrony and the rhythms and the sort of interactions that are occurring at both a biological level and a behavioral level during interactions. And our hope is that using that information and using better understanding and models of those types of interactions, that we can understand how to better support those who struggle with social interaction, like children on the autism spectrum often do. My real hope is that this research will eventually lead to much better understanding of the sort of complex interrelationship between people, and particularly across development. I think that relationships and social interactions, again, on both a behavioral and sort of a biological level, are tremendously important. And my work so far has really suggested to me that they may be even more important than many of us realize. And I think that understanding how those are involved in development could lead us to better ways to provide intervention to children who struggle with some of these aspects of social relatedness. And I think if we could understand how to assess and understand what a child is struggling with in that domain early on, we could provide better, more targeted intervention that could have an important lasting effect.
Thank you.